Hi, I'm Luke Moore and I'm here with Stephen Fletcher from Life in Theatre Productions.
Hello, Luke.
Hello, Stephen. How are you?
Very well. We've just been hijacked by a wedding party who just left this wonderful St George's Hall.
Don't they? They look wonderful.
They're marvellous. They look absolutely lovely.
Absolutely beautiful. Stephen and I know each other from a production at the Epstein Theatre. That was the last 5 years.
Yes.
So I thought I'd just actually take an opportunity to catch up with him after a wonderful run of The Sunshine Boys. How do you feel that went?
Really well, actually. It was part of Sunshine Boys was part of a Broadway double bill, if you like. We brought The Last 5 Years, which is a two-hander musical with myself and Helen Carter. And we were on for about 3 weeks, was it? Three weeks in total, with Luke, Emily and Nick Phillips on keys. And then our second part of that was The Sunshine Boys by Neil Simon. And we were trying to bring a real eclectic mix of brand new theatre and kind of an old classic, Broadway classic. But it went really well, everyone seemed to enjoy it. And off to passes new now. I don't know what that's going to be, but we'll wait and see.
Absolutely. Well, I was very lucky to see the last but one performance of The Sunshine Boys. It was wonderful, the cast, the set. To see the Epstein dressed up as it was was absolutely amazing. So from my point of view, well done. The one thing I noticed is the audience really seemed to key into the sense of humour, the vaudeville comedy. Is that the kind of thing you'd like to repeat in the future, that kind of style?
I think so, yeah. It's something that Liverpool likes a laugh, that's fair to say. Well, everyone likes a laugh, but Liverpool tends to enjoy that kind of humour. And I think for a long time, a certain type of audience has been only used to Liverpool-centric plays. And there's such a wealth of writing out there, both new and old classics, that people haven't been exposed to. And The Sunshine Boys is one of them, I think. It could have been a Scouse play, that witty, kind of fast, sardonic, quite dark humour and quick-wittedness, do you know what I mean? That you've cracked about 5 jokes before someone has even got one out, you know what I mean? So anyway, that was kind of the idea with that kind of play. And with someone like Drew Schofield playing the role that an audience knows and trusts, Alan Stocks, they play the double act, and a very collaborative feel with one of the actresses, Helen Carter, as well as being in The Last 5 Years. She also designed the costumes for the show. Michael Fletcher, my brother, he played a small role in the show, but he also designed the set. So it's old school vaudeville in a way, really. Actors doing it for themselves, getting up on a stage and presenting to an audience,
Yeah, absolutely wonderful, like I said. I'd like to know, how did Life in Theatre come about? What was your dream that started that? And where do you see it going in the next few years?
Well, Life in Theatre Productions was named actually after the very first play that we did. It was a two-hander with myself and Andrew Schofield. With myself and Andrew Schofield, and it was written by David Mamet about two old actors, or an old actor, Drew played that, and me kind of starting out backstage, talking about the plays that they've done together, the experience of this old wise actor and this new young book trying to make it in the world. We did 2 weeks in a production of that in Liverpool, the Actor's Studio, which went really well, and from then on I realised that there was a bit of a gap in the market, so. And a lot of it was born out of making work for ourselves and sick of waiting for the phone to ring, for your agent to maybe call, for you to be dragged through the mill of auditions and then not get a job. It's just about taking a bit of control and doing it ourselves. So that was only a year and a half ago now. And we're now about to move on to our fifth production. So it's an ambitious start, and I think, you know, we've got a good audience that have come with us. Our biggest show was Mamma Mia, which we did at the Dome at Central Hall over Christmas time. And again, that was born out of a large group of people not having a job. Got together, wrote the play, got permission off the original writers and directors of Mamma Mia. Had some financial support off them because they realised what we were trying to do. And we managed to get nearly 10,000 people to come and see our show. So that's the start of our database now. And it's about introducing people to more varied productions than just naturally the make them laugh type stuff. You know, give people a bit more.
Absolutely, it sounds wonderful, and having had first-hand experience as an audience member and somebody working with you, it's a very amazing thing that you're trying to do with Life in Theatre, so I certainly applaud that. I've got to ask, in terms of influences, whether that's other theatre companies, actors or directors, or any favourite plays, what feeds into your process as an actor?
I was saying this earlier, I think it's more to do with people that I've had first-hand experience with, you know, a connection with, either through employment or not getting a job from them, or and actually seeing how people work in a room rather than looking at a play or a film and thinking I want to be like them. I'd much rather see what their process is. And I think the biggest one for me is a director who, funnily enough, directed Mamma Mia, the original musical, as well as millions of operas. That's kind of a thing that she's known for. A director called Phyllida Lloyd, who I worked with at the Donmar in London and transferred to the West End. And seeing the way she worked, she's very collaborative, very open to suggestions from other actors. That's not to say that she's bad and there's a void, and she'll let other people do the work, which is what a lot of other directors tend to do, I think. She's very open to saying, I've got an idea, but what do you think? And she wants to know what that actor instinctively wants to do, and I think that's someone that I would like to replicate, or at least, you know, what's the word?
Emulate,
yeah. That's the word. I nearly said emanate them, but that's...
You can emanate
complete,
them as well.
I'll emanate them as well. Yeah, I'll laminate them. I'll laminate them later. Yeah, so Phyllida Lloyd's kind of a bit of a hero for me, I think. Actors, I don't know. People, there's loads of great actors. I love Drew. I love what Andrew Schofield does. I like more his work ethic and his attitude towards... His motto is probably make it swing where you live and it's only a play. I mean, it's kind of a real grounded view of the industry, really. You know, what's the worst that can happen? And again, I remember another director that I worked with said, when they asked, are you nervous about being in this production? I said, no. And someone leant forward and said, that's Stephen's problem. He doesn't want it enough. And I thought, well, no, that's completely wrong. It's actually that I know that if I forgot my lines, if I fell over, which I've done both, I'm still here. Do you know what I mean? It isn't the end of the world. So it's finding the balance between that, wanting it enough to get it right, and also not killing yourself if it was to go wrong.
So, of course, we're here in Liverpool, a wonderful city culturally, yes. With everything that's happened over more centuries than the last few years. A lot of people forget that, I guess. You said people have been very supportive, and you've got the audience, you've got the database now. How would you compare Liverpool theatrically to, rather than theatrically compare Liverpool, that is, how would you compare Liverpool theatrically to other big cities, places like, of course, Manchester, only 40 minutes away, yeah. London and so on. How would you say it sits amongst those?
Well, I suppose I'm soaked in Liverpool, really. I mean, you can get a bit scoused out, I suppose. And I think that could be said for some of the plays that are on offer. You know, if it's not Liverpool, then people won't go and see it. I think that's wrong to say that. But there could be a tendency where people do... It takes a while to take that leap and watch something that might be out of your comfort zone. I've experienced that first time with trying to bring these two different plays. Of course, you can always get more people coming to watch it. But those that did were surprised. Some people hadn't even heard of Neil Simon, you know, which sounds like sacrilege to me. But that's only because I'm around it. I know I know various things about that play and about that type of show. But I think there's enough of a mix in Liverpool for people to have lots of choice. There's the subsidised theatres that have the ability to offer a wide range, a bit of a Swiss Army knife, I suppose, of different tastes of plays that you can dip in and out of. You've got the Royal Court, which offers, you know, a huge array of plays, really, that do offer a similar kind of theme. It's very Liverpool, but they are veering away from that with more, more diverse programmes of events. They've got Lennon on at the moment. Not just plays, musicals, but they offer a package. They offer a night out. You get a meal, you get a drink. It's the event type theatre. Empire, of course, you've got the touring productions. There is a great, array of stuff, the Unity. So I think it's in a really good shape. But I think at the moment what's happening is, as a response to employment and people not getting jobs, lots of people are doing what I'm doing, really. It's time for DIY. In a bit of a gap, you have to fill that with something. And whether that be lots of people doing their own work, I think that can only lead to a positive future, with lots of people creating what they want to create and people coming on board and shaping that for the future. So I can't really speak for other cities, having not necessarily worked greatly in them, but I know that the wrong attitude is to have that if it's not London, then it's not any good. And I think that kind of leads to that drain that happens naturally, where people want to be down there and want to be part of either the West End or all those great wonderful places where there's thousands of people all fighting for the same thing. And although I did that for a time, I realised that I wanted to do more than that, and change stuff from where I'm from, I think. So we'll see how it goes anyway.
Absolutely wonderful, Stephen. Thanks very much. How can people find more about Life in Theatre? Where can they keep up to date with what you're up to?
lifeintheatre.webs.com. We've also got a YouTube channel, so if you want to see snippets of our shows, you can go on there. Also, Twitter and Facebook, just have a look for us on there, Life in Theatre.
Brilliant. Thanks very much. Stephen Fletcher from Life in Theatre. I've been Luke Moore. Thank you.
Cheers, Luke.